This week, we're moving away from Apple's reminders, iCloud, calendar, and email, and I'm going to be looking at a feature that Apple has that doesn't get spoken about a lot, but that really can help you with your productivity, and that's the Read Later feature in Safari. And if you use any Apple device, whether that's an iPad, a laptop, a desktop, or an iPhone, then you have this feature built into your Safari. And it is quite a powerful little tool if you want to be able to keep articles for reading later. And what's more special about this is reading later offline. So if you're flying anywhere, which maybe you're not doing at the moment, but if you're traveling or if you're in a place where there's no Wi-Fi and you want to save on your data, then this is a fantastic feature to use. And it really does help me to get through the day with reading articles that I want to read of interest. So before we go any further, just let me ask you, if you do get any value from this episode, then please hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on Apple productivity apps, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my mobile Safari and my desktop Safari and show you how Read Later works. Okay, so for those of us who are, those of you who are wanting some kind of very easy Read Later feature or function, then Safari on both iOS and macOS, which I'm using here, will do that for you. It's actually a really good system, and there's a few little hidden features in there that I would find particularly useful if you are flying or you're traveling, which probably we're not doing very much of at the moment. But if you go into the, let's take the Todoist blog, which is a place that I actually visit quite frequently. Now, if you haven't noticed already this week that Todoist have just launched a new view in their version, so if we click on that, and let's just say I'm in a bit of a rush, it's early morning, I'm just catching up with the news, what can I do? Well, if you go to the share sheet over here, so you go to the share function there, tap on that, and you can immediately just add to reading list, and bang, it's gone. Now, that's now going to be available on all your iOS devices. So if you use an iPad or you use an iPhone, then that is going to be available now. Now, the thing is, what you can do is you can go over here and you'll see that it has now joined my other articles that I've got written in there. And by the way, you can actually pull this out if you wish, and you can make that bigger or you can make that quite small. I can actually drag it out, but I'm going to have it there. You can actually filter this by unread and read. So I've read most of them, but I haven't read that one. So if I wanted to, I could just show my unread only, which is there. So once I'm in here, if I just slide across using my there, I can say save offline, tap that. Now that means now that even if I don't have a internet connection, let's say I'm flying somewhere, I now have this available to me whenever I'm offline. So basically I can read this anywhere, anytime. And if you're traveling in another country and you don't want to incur the extra charges of roaming, then here's another great way to save articles. So they're very, really good. And you also have the ability to search for articles in there too. At the moment, obviously I have one. So that's that, and that's going to show up in my iOS devices on my phone. And we'll just go over there now and I will show you how that is operating. Okay, so here I am on my iPhone, and what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna show more because I've got the Todoist blog there. And so we're gonna take the next blog here, which is how to easily make the switch from Wunderlist to Todoist before May the 6th. So if I tap on that one, and let's say I want to save this for offline reading. And just like you did with the, when you're using it with a laptop or using it on the web, all you do is the share sheet down at the bottom there, and you can drag down there and you can just see add to reading list. Just tap that and that's now gone into my reading list. So what I'm going to do is I go over there now and I've got the two things in my reading list. And so I can actually show unread or show all. I only have these two in here now because I've deleted the others. So show all. And there we go. I have those in there. So if I need to go, if I want to go back and read them, I can just tap on that and bang, I'm in and I can read it. Now there's something else that you can do. On your iPhone, you can set this up to automatically show for offline reading. And this is one of the things that I find is unless you actually set it up, 90% of the time you probably never need it because you can use the Wi-Fi when you're at home. But there's going to be an occasion where suddenly you don't have Wi-Fi or you don't have access to Wi-Fi, and you're going to thank yourself that you actually set this up. So what we do is we go into settings. So if you go into settings here, and you just from the main settings menu, go down and find Safari, which is generally somewhere down at the bottom here. There we go, it's Safari there. Tap on that. And again, if you go down to the very bottom, you'll see reading list, automatically save offline. And you can tap this for on and off. I would suggest that you turn this for on so that this automatically, anything that you save from your phone will automatically go and be available for offline reading. Now, the beauty of this is that you have quick access to this at any time, and you can edit this, by the way. You can just tap these and you can then decide delete them, which is really quick if you wish. You can do all sorts of things from there. And again, if you swipe there, you can delete them as you go through, and so you have action for them as well. And there is all sorts of things that you can do in here, and they're just really, really good ways of managing your reading list on your phone. And there you go. So for those of you who don't want a third party read later service, Safari on your iOS device and on your Mac device gives you a lot of options that you can do. And you can actually, if you just drag down, by the way, you can search for lists as well. So you can search for all sorts of things if you start getting a full list. So there you go. I wanted to show you that because I find that particularly useful. And I have used that so many times, particularly for offline reading when I know I'm going to fly. I generally start saving articles into there. And this is just my demo phone, so I don't have very much in it. But on my main phone, it is a service that I use a lot, and I get a lot of value from it, particularly for research articles if I don't have full time to actually read it. And other things that I may want to tweet this out or send it to Facebook later, again, I will just save it to my reading list, and I can have quick access to the article that I want to read. So there you go. Just a quick tip for you using Safari, something that I wasn't expecting to bring into an Apple productivity series, but it is productivity because you can use this to help save yourself a lot of time for reading later. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my Learning Center and is incredible value, and it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, Reminders and Calendar, into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.